Good afternoon, children. Once again, welcome to online classes. See, children, just we got the message that this year 8 standard syllabus has been changed. So I'm very sorry to tell this, but still textbooks have not come. But I have completed that whole syllabus only. Two lessons, one from chemistry and one from biology. Okay, let it be. You keep it for the bridge course and all. So you can read those questions only. Based on that syllabus only, we have to take bridge course. So for this academic year, so syllabus has been changed, science and maths. So they have converted it to CBSE syllabus. So you can download the textbook if you want from the Google. Nothing, just you have to type the Karnataka syllabus.
Various activities.
activities of our body. Okay. First one, to get energy. What do you mean by to get energy? Yes. Day to day, every day, from right from morning till we sleep night, we do lot of activities like working, sleeping, talking, jumping, screaming, shouting, everything we do. For each and everything we need energy. Suppose if I move from this place to this place, okay, even I need energy. Suppose I want to lift this book from some other place, okay, I want to keep it on some other place, for that also we need energy. Suppose if I tell you to lift the bench from one place to another place, for that also we need energy. Then where do you get this energy? Obviously, we get energy from the food what we eat. Isn't it? Yes. We get energy from the food what we intake. So for that, first source of the food is to get energy. So we are doing lot of work, including children, including adults, including man, woman, everybody, old man, everybody will do some or the other work. For each and everybody, we need energy to do some work. Housewives, we do cooking, washing clothes and washing utensils, everything, cleaning the house. For each and everything, even to sleep also we need energy, isn't it? Suppose if you start for 2 to 3 days without food, fill you for without 2 to 3 days without food, can you walk on the third day? Suppose if I tell you to run without the food, from 2 to 3 days you are not have taken the food. Okay, if I tell you to run on the fourth day, can you run, children? No, because you tell that no, ma'am, we don't have energy. From 2 to 3 days I didn't have anything. Yes, without food we cannot get the energy. So food is a very essential part of our life. Next, to grow. Yes, to grow. Obviously, we are growing day by day, isn't it? Even you were very small when you have taken birth, isn't it? Now we have grown up to the extended. Means without food, how can you grow? Yes, food is an essential need for our growth of our body. We need food for the growth of our body. Next, for repair of our body. Yes, many times, especially boys will get more hurt whenever they play, they ride bicycle, they ride two-wheelers and all, they fall sometimes in the ground. While playing also they run, sometimes while fighting also they may get hurt, they get wound on the skin and all. So to repair these wounds and all, to heal itself, so we need energy. The whatever the food we take, some vitamins, proteins, everything will be present in that food. It helps to repair the part of the body where we have got the wound, isn't it? Yes. Next, for various activities of our body. Yes, respiration, circulation of the blood, digestion, everything, for various activities of the functions of our body. Many types of functions are going in our body, isn't it? Without that functions we cannot survive. So those all functions are in order, then only we can do our activities properly, isn't it? If any other function stops it, we will be sick, we fall sick. So to move in that functions will be in the movement. For that also we need food. Okay, so food is a main source. From these things we came to know that food is very essential part of our body. So without food we cannot survive. So where does we get this food? Obviously, India is our country. We all know that India's occupation is agriculture. Agriculture is nothing but the growing crops in the field. Most of the Indians have that occupation, agriculture. Yes, they grow many types of crops, isn't it? Many types of crops in the fields. Mostly you know that farmers are called backbone of our nation. If they can't grow these all, if they can't struggle in that field, we cannot eat the food, we cannot survive, because they are the backbone of our nation. They are struggling hard in the field, so only we are sitting and eating nice, delicious food on the dining table here. This is main credit goes to the farmers who are putting their efforts, who are bringing their crops and all, everything yields very in the golden way. So we are credit to farmers. We should be very credited to the farmers, isn't it? Yes. So crop production. What is a crop production? How do they grow? Yes. For that, first thing, many types of vegetables, cereals, pulses are grown in the crops. Yes. But we cannot grow all the types of vegetables, all the types of cereals, all the types of pulses in the same season. There are some different seasons which different cereals and pulses are grown. Okay. In the two types of crops are grown. That is called kharif crops. Kharif crops. Okay. Kharif crops. These crops which are in the, grown in the rainy season. Which are grown in the rainy season. Okay. These crops are grown in rainy season. Rainy season. So rainy season, usually in India, rainy season comes between June to September. June to September. Okay. In this season only these crops are grown. What are those crops? For example, these examples are paddy, maize, soybean. Okay, soybean, cotton, etc. Okay, so these are called as kharif crops. These are called as kharif crops. These are grown only in rainy season. In India, rainy season comes between June to September. And what are those cereals which are grown in rainy season? Paddy, maize, soybean, cotton, etc. Some others also are there. So I gave only four examples. Okay, these are the pulses which are grown in the rainy season. One more crops, that is rabi crops. Rabi crops. Rabi crops are, these crops are grown in the, these crops are grown in the winter season. In the winter season. So winter season comes from the month of, usually in the month of October to March. Okay, these here examples, which are those pulses? Grams, pea, mustard, and linseed. So these are the examples which are crops grown in the winter season. Winter season comes in the in between October to March. Okay. So grams, pea, mustard, and linseed. Linseed means nothing but the flax seeds. Agsay. In Kannada it is called as agsay. So these are all grown in the winter seasons. Okay. So we have these two types of crops. Okay. Kharif crops and rabi crops. So all the pulses, all the vegetables, all the cereals are not grown in all the days. So they have some specific time. They have to be sown in that time only, and they will grow in that time only. So as I told you, in the rainy season and in the winter season. Rainy season are nothing but the kharif crops. These crops are grown in the rainy seasons. Examples are paddy, maize, soybean, cotton. So rabi crops, these crops are grown in the winter season. Examples are grams, pea, mustard, and linseed. Okay, so these are the crops. We came to know that we have two types of crops. Yes, grown in some particular times like that. So before sowing the seeds, okay, what farmers will do, what are those the instruments which they use to plow the field and all. So that is called as agricultural practices. That is called as agricultural practices or agriculture practice. Agriculture practice. What is that? Nothing but how they fertilize the soil. So once the crops are grown in the soil, again we have to remove those crops and all. So we have to clean that soil. So cleaning means we have to loosen that soil. We have to tilt that soil with the help of the plow. I think you know plow. Plow is nothing but negilu. In Kannada it is called as negilu. Okay, farmers used to plow the field. So that is called as plow. So what are those all things? What are the factors? How they depend? And what are the procedures to sow the seeds and to grow the crops? So everything I will continue in the next video. Okay, I hope you got that. Please download that textbook from the Google for time being till you get the textbook from our school. So go through that, download it, and I am starting with the new syllabus only. Okay children, please continue. I will continue in the next video. Thank you.